Texas Instruments' new TCAN4550-Q1 BoosterPack is a general-purpose board to evaluate the CANFD controller rapidly and easily with a variety of TI microcontrollers. The supply voltage and CANFD bus signals are available on an industry-standard DB9 connector, allowing for easy integration into text fixtures and wiring harnesses. The main difference between the BoosterPack and the TCAN4550 EVM is that the BoosterPack uses a standardized pinout for TI launchpads, allowing you to effortlessly connect a microcontroller and the BoosterPack. For this video, we're going to use an MSP430 FR6989 launchpad. To connect the BoosterPack to the launchpad, simply push them together, taking care to ensure that you do not damage any of the pins. Power can be supplied via J2 with a standard 12-volt power supply barrel jack connector or through the DB9 connector. Next, we need to ensure that the shunt for power is properly selected to either the barrel jack or the DB9 connector. Also check that the termination resistor shunts are populated. Now we connect the USB cable to the launchpad and our computer, and turn on power to the setup. Now on our computer, we will import our downloaded example code into Code Composer Studio by navigating to Project, Import CCS Projects, navigating to the example code install location, and pressing OK. Then click Finish to copy the code to your workspace. This example code is very basic and will configure the TCAN4550 to send two CAN messages and then wait to receive one. In my test setup, I have two boards. One is already flashed with this example code. I will show you how we can see the incoming CAN message with the use of the debugger. I will place a breakpoint on the line after the message is read from the TCAN4550-Q1. This will make the MCU halt when a CAN message is received successfully. Launch the debugger by pressing the bug icon at the top. Once the debugger has flashed the launchpad, you should look at the TCAN4550-Q1 booster pack and make sure that the green LED labeled VCC out is on. The TCAN4550-Q1 has a power saving feature that will put it to sleep if no microcontroller activity has been detected within about 4 minutes of power up. If the VCC out light is not on, then press the reset or wake button on the booster pack to wake it up. Once the VCC out LED is on, you are ready to press the play button and start code execution. At this point, you would send a CAN message to the TCAN4550-Q1. I will do this by pressing switch 1 on the launch pad to get it to send a CAN message. There are several CAN tools outside of TI that allow you to send a message to the booster pack. Now that my device has received the CAN message, the microcontroller has halted at the breakpoint. Using Code Composer's variables view, we can view the message header object's contents by clicking on the drop-down arrow next to the name. In my program, I right-clicked on the message header object and changed the number format to hexadecimal, but you can view this however you prefer. Here we can see the TCAN4550-Q1 received a CAN message with an ID of hex 123. The data length code is 4, which equals 4 bytes of CAN payload data. Note, for values greater than 8, it does not equal the number of bytes received. Refer to the TCAN4550-Q1 datasheet for more information. To view the received data, scroll to the data payload array and view the first 4 objects. Again, I chose to view this data in hexadecimal format. Here we can see that the received data was hex 11, hex 22, hex 33, and hex 44, which matches what was sent. For more information on these functions, I recommend that you refer to the TCAN4550-Q1 Software User's Guide, which can be found by visiting the link below. I also recommend that you take some time to look through the documentation folder included with this example code. The index.html file will take you to the homepage, which allows you to view all the functions and the behaviors of each one. Thanks for watching this brief video on how to use the booster pack to quickly prototype the TCAN4550-Q1.